The clinical stage stem cell company ReNeuron has been busy recently publishing a raft of news from the completion for a phase one clinical trial on its RENE001 stroke treatment, the green light to begin phase one clinical trials on its RENE009 stem cell therapy for critical limb ischemia. This is the medical term used to describe deficiency of blood to an area of tissue. And also the news of a new collaboration that enables ReNeuron to advance development of its pipeline of treatments. Michael Hunt joins us now on the phone. He's the chief executive of ReNeuron. Michael, good to talk to you.
Good afternoon.
Let's go first of all with this collaboration, if we can. It's with a company called Cell Therapy Catapult. What's it mean for ReNeuron investors?
Well, the Cell Therapy Catapult was established very recently, actually, and it's a government-backed organization with a remit to promote and build a flourishing UK-based cell therapy industry. So, of course, we regard ourselves as a pure stem cell therapy business as fitting quite comfortably within the sights of what the Catapult is trying to achieve. So we've established a collaboration with them to really to accelerate certain aspects of our cell manufacturing technologies. So in other words, to try and leverage some of the resources that the Catapult can bring to bear, which we couldn't otherwise do ourselves, or at least not as quickly.
Well, let's look at that collaboration in the context then of the pipeline progression at ReNeuron and tied in with the recent news surrounding these treatments for critical limb ischemia and stroke. How does this new relationship oil the pipeline wheels, if you like?
Well, quite simply because the main focus of the Catapult collaboration relates to our CTX stem cell line, which is the stem cell product, if you will, that's used in both the stroke program and the critical limb ischemia program. So CTX as a cell line is vital to our therapeutic pipeline, which makes the collaboration with the Catapults clearly very important for us.
What about funding for all this?
Well, the collaboration with the Catapult will enable us to accelerate the program using resources that the Catapult will bring to bear, but we would have otherwise had to have gone out and, if you like, bought ourselves. So in that sense, it brings further financial resources into the business. And over and above that, of course, we'll use our own resources to drive those therapeutic programs forward in due course.
Well, let's take a look now at where you go from here. What are the milestones that investors should watch out for from the news surrounding these two stem cell therapies I spoke about at the top?
Well, the next thing we have to do, obviously, with the both the critical limb ischemia phase one program and shortly thereafter the stroke phase two program is to get them started, to actually start dosing patients in both of those new clinical trials. So that's the first milestone. And then, of course, thereafter, in time, as those trials proceed, we would be looking to roll out the data that that comes from those trials once we've treated the patients that we're recruiting into those studies.
And what sort of timetable are you looking at in terms of dates and the amount of time it's going to take?
Both trials should actually be relatively swift. The critical limb ischemia trial we would envisage lasting for about a year or so, and the stroke phase two study somewhere in the order of 18 months. So they are both relatively short studies in terms of timelines. And in that context, we'd hope to be able to announce something in the not too distant future. Obviously, as we recruit into those studies and get the patients followed up.
Okay, Michael. Well, good luck with all that, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you,
Michael Hunt, chief executive of ReNeuron.